guys, what's up? So I have had a request or two for my floor version to the ab video that I request or that I requested that I recorded on Monday. I had done it off of like a box, like a bench thingy, and I showed before I did it, I showed how to do it off of the floor and what kind of moves to use to kind of modify what I was doing off of the box. But really, you're doing the same exact thing, and I don't know if I was really sore, but I tried to record it yesterday and I thought it was harder than actually doing it on the incline off of the box, because you have more leg help when you're off of the box than you do when you're down. You have more like thigh help. So it's, I don't know, do both of them, see what you like better, see which one works better for you. You do use a lot more of your back muscles when you do it inclined the way that we did it the other day. So I would maybe even suggest doing one on the floor and then doing one on the box and see how you do with that. But if you're feeling any strain on the floor, if you're new to this whole workout thing and your core is not exactly as strong as you would like it right now, if you need a little bit more help, it's totally fine to put a pillow underneath. Just sort of, I'll actually just get in position here where we're going to be. Wedge a pillow right underneath you right here, kind of sit just a little bit on it, on the edge of it, and then when you go down and you keep your back nice and straight, you're going to have that pillow for support and kind of show you where to stop, where you're not going too far, you're going back far enough to where you're getting the effects of the workout too and building that core strength. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. Anchor your feet underneath something. Take breaks whenever you need them. You're not going to necessarily take breaks when I take them. I don't know how many I'm going to take. This, again, is the practice round for me, since yesterday was sort of a bust and I only got halfway through and thought, okay, no, I took way too many breaks and I can't do this. So I'm going to try and muscle through and do it with as few breaks as possible. But like I said, if I break and you don't feel like you need to break yet, then go ahead and keep going. I'm going to keep talking to you regardless. So just follow my voice. Maybe not necessarily what I'm doing all the time. Okay. So feet are anchored. You're coming back to 45 degrees. Grab underneath your legs. Get your back nice and straight. Okay, let go. Twist. Look straight up to the ceiling. You're just moving your shoulders. Okay, you're not really moving the arms. It's the shoulders. Get ready. Next move. Fingertips behind your ears. Elbows. Down. Up. Really reaching back.
Sorry. up.
It hurts. I promise it's hurting me too. Break. Shake it off. Rock it back and forth. 1, 2, there we go. One, two, pulse. Breathe. Now we're just gonna rock. 1, 2, 3. Just little pulses here. Keep going. Okay, that hurt real bad. So, I felt all of that right here, my hip flexors, all of it, all up right here. I definitely think it is just as hard as the box workout, but like I said, you're targeting the same muscles, and you're doing the same moves. It's hard to explain, but you're reaping the benefit of it from both. You're getting back in it still, so if you can. But if you can do the box one after you do the floor one, maybe get a little bit more back in there if your back is still, if your core is capable of that full, unsupervised kind of help, if you didn't need the pillow or anything like that and you feel like you can move up, definitely do so. But listen to your body. Don't overdo it. Don't strain yourself. Build up. And let me know how you liked it. If you did both videos, I want to know what you thought about both workouts. So, because I think they're equally just as hard. I had to break just as much on the floor as I did on the box. So, okay. Thanks, guys. See ya.